The main problem could be the CPU, I think. X99 is pretty heavy to bench. For me, it is definitely the hardest platform I've ever benched. Although I just benched on cold for 2 years now, but it's pretty heavy. You have a cold bug, which is not a real cold bug, you know, from the past. You have to take care of temperatures while the CPU is in idle. It's a totally difference between idle and load. So yeah, it's pretty heavy. X99 is not easy to bench.
Of course, I think the first and second team, of course, with 8-pack and the Dutch-German team. So we'll try to do our best and see what we can do.
To have luck, if you don't have a good graphic card, and when you have 75% of the score coming from 3D benchmark, if your graphic card are worse than other participants, you have no luck to win. So you just have to hope to have good hardware and a lot of luck, and then you can do your best to be better. But every contestant are really good and have skills, so yeah, the key is luck.
I think the main challenge will be the Fire Strike, normal and extreme.
I think it's Fire Strike, extreme and Cinebench, because we have to do everything and find the max of our card and CPU as quick as possible in order to manage to be on the top of the rankings, actually. That's it.
Well, I think the main challenge is, as with all live events, is getting everything to come together at once and managing the time well. I mean, because you've got such a long time to submit the Fire Strike benchmarks, doesn't mean to say that you shouldn't get a score in on all benchmarks pretty early. I think because Cinebench is weighted quite low, and obviously you've only got a very short period of time to finish that, I think that's one just to get out of the way and then just focus on 3D, but maybe run all 3D benchmarks straight away, get scores in, and then try and improve your scores, starting with 11 because the cutoff time is earlier than Fire Strike and Fire Strike Extreme. And tweaking accordingly. I think as with all live competitions, the challenge is to solve the problems with the system that you see while you're running, and then maximise each score in the time period allowed.
I think the main challenge is the time management. To get the best scores in time it's quite difficult, because some people they tend to focus on one benchmark for too long. And then they forget that they maybe have to pre-test for another benchmark first and to test the clocks for the card. So actually the time management and the binning for the CPU is the most important part, yeah.